In this video, I will talk about the risks of serverless computing. And this is based on a report that the Israeli Cloud Security Alliance chapter has produced. First, we need to discuss what is serverless. I'm having an example on the right, which I'll explain in a second. Serverless is a platform as a service offering offered by most cloud providers. Amazon calls it Lambda, Google calls it Cloud Functions, Azure calls it Azure Functions, as you would guess. And it is an event-driven architecture where you, as a consumer, bring function code that will then be executed by the cloud provider in a completely scalable and pay-per-use way. So you actually pay for an individual function invocation. Now, how does this work in the reality? Here's an example that is based on, this example is a very common pattern where you put data in a storage bucket. So the user labeled one is putting data in the S3 bucket, which is labeled two, and the S3 bucket is configured to call an Amazon Lambda function when something is put in that bucket. Now, the Lambda function, your piece of code, assumes an execution rule that gives it certain permissions and it allows it to do certain things like process the data or send it somewhere else based on some kind of rule. And this is the core architecture of serverless and the building block of a complete serverless architecture. Now, what about serverless risks? Because every new technology has new risks. The title of the report that the CSA chapter produced is The 12 Most Critical Risks for Serverless Applications 2019, which promises a new version in 2020. Well, let's see if that is going to help or if that is going to work. Here's the URL, but you can probably Google that easily. It's a mid-sized document, and for each of those 12 risks, it describes the risks, the particular risk. It gives an example of how to exploit it, compares the serverless approach on that risk in relation to the risk that you would have in a more traditional application architecture, and it explains how to mitigate that particular risk. A number of approaches for mitigating that risk. And the summary of what it's all about, and then I'll go into a bit more detail on specific risks, is that many well-known risks associated to application software reappear in serverless, but they have a new incarnation. They look different and they play out in a different way. An example being the OS risks such as SQL injection, where you let the code execute stuff that it's not supposed to execute, wrongly configured credentials, access rights, and all that stuff. The report does highlight the differences between these two styles of application development or application architecture. And it actually gives a lot of examples of function architectures and exploits. And there is actual code in that document as well. And as I said, a lot of mitigation tactics are there. Overall, I like the document very much, although I think that it could use a bit of a roadmap and a quote-unquote where to begin advice, because the whole field is fairly overwhelming to a lot of people, I suspect. So let's dive into a subset of these 12 risks. First one, function in event data injection. And this is a reincarnation of the SQL injection problem. As a matter of fact, SQL injection can still happen in serverless as well. But the attack surface is now much wider. There are all kinds of API interfaces that lead into that function that you may have a little less visibility on. And there's a great example of a piece of code in the document here as well. Overprivileged function permissions and roles. Well, in a way, we know that already. I remember pieces of software that I had to install on Windows that really required to be run as administrator because they couldn't access certain files, which is complete overkill and a security risk. Now, in serverless, functions have access rights, for example, to access the database. And if you have many functions, you'll have many rights, and ideally, you will have different rights. And these rights should be as restricted as possible. And the rights for one function should not automatically be granted to all the other functions. That would be sloppiness in design. So this entire rights and access control structure should be part of the design of that application. Next up, inadequate function monitoring and logging. On your old school server, if you still have one, a lot of application logging is sort of consolidated and uniform by the definition, by approach. As functions are more standalone and are deployed independently, you will find that that consolidated approach is not by default there. So you have to create it. Now, it is doable to create that, obviously. And if you do automation in your deployment process, it might actually be done in an automatic way. However, you have to pay attention to how to do it, because if you don't, you won't get the visibility in that function, and you will find no other way of getting visibility into that function. In your old school server, you could still log in and turn on the debugger and all that stuff. Impossible in serverless. Next up, insecure application secret storage. Again, something that gets a new lease on life, so to say. You might remember PHP scripts that had the password of the database server in there. Well, it still happens. We can make these mess ups now on a much wider scale. As I indicated earlier, different functions should have different access rules. And that might imply that there are many more application secrets that are required for the deployment. The other thing is that functions will be deployed more automatically and partially, which will require automatic key distribution at scale. It's no longer possible or conceivable to start up a server, log into it, then enter the database password for it to run. It doesn't work that way. These serverless functions don't live long enough for that to be economically viable. And this automatic key distribution at scale is something that developers find hard to do. And if they find it hard to do, it's not gonna happen. It's not gonna happen, really. Then, number 8, denial of service and financial resource exhaustion. So serverless is incredibly scalable. You know, you can have a function run once every month or 100 times a second. And there's no automatic limit to that. As a matter of fact, there are a lot of resources that you even don't know that could be exhausted. CPU time is one of them, because serverless functions typically run for a very limited time. And there's a denial of service attack possible through that. But you'll also have your monthly bill or the set of IP addresses that you need to scale to a certain level. So this requires additional attention to those limits and the management of those limits. Then the last one I'm going to use, cross-execution data persistency. This is an example that is, of all the risks that are in the report, to my mind, it's the most serverless specific. So this has to do with the underlying technology for serverless functions. If functions are run typically on a container, and if the next invocation of that function is done within, let's say, a couple of seconds, then it might land on the same container and might have access to data that is stored on that container by the previous invocation of that same function in the, let's say, the temporary directory. And this opens up an avenue for data leakage from one invocation to another. And these invocations might be called by different users with different access rights. So there it is. Now, there's also not mentioned in the report, I'll tell you that here, there are some advantage of serverless when it comes to security, because the underlying libraries that you write your code in will be patched and updated by the provider. And because the server, the underlying container, and depending on the provider, of course, but at Amazon, the underlying container will never live more than 5 minutes. So if there is a vulnerability and the patch process works, then the vulnerability will not last longer than 5 minutes, almost by definition. In conclusion, if you are developing serverless application architectures, if you're reviewing them, then I say that this report is a must read. And you can go to the Cloud Security Alliance website to get your copy of it.
Thanks for watching. My name is Peter van Eyck, and this is the YouTube channel Club Cloud Computing. Please like the video and subscribe to the channel.